it's really great that you don't have to be the prototypical, you don't have to be Bruce Lee. You don't have to be tall and lithe and fast. It's great if you are. A lot of the guys in our club are. I am not. But I can still do the sport and enjoy it and get a lot out of it.
Freshman Andrew Shin has been involved in Taekwondo since he was 5. He says there's more to it than just the enjoyment.
I think Taekwondo in a lot of ways keeps you fit. It's a Taekwondo match, for example. It's like 90%, 95% kicking. So you're going to emphasize a lot of leg calisthenic drills. You're going to do flexibility drills. You're going to do, you know, push-ups also. You're going to throw punches. You're going to do a lot of core work. It's actually a whole body workout. I think whether or not you want to compete in Taekwondo, Taekwondo's a great way to stay fit overall. It's a lot of fun too. You're on your feet. It's very easy to start, not a very high learning curve.
To be honest, it started off with just wanting to exercise, and Taekwondo, I think there's a good combination of kind of like working on agility and getting some cardio exercises at the same time. So ultimately, that's why I kind of just stuck with it. And it was also for cultural reasons. I mean, just being a Korean and Taekwondo being a Korean martial art and all, just thought that would fit in well.
Shin says that people with no experience are really able to appreciate the martial art.
And then usually it's the kicking that really gets them engaged and involved in Taekwondo. I think just getting them to kick a pad a few times, it's a unique motion that people really haven't done too much of. You know, raising your leg above your waist, you know, people are like, oh, I'm not very flexible, but seeing themselves being able to kick a target like chest high, it gives them a lot of confidence, and that's what makes it fun, I think, for a beginner.